All right, we're live over the Corpse Party Blood Drive finale. Once again, as usual, if you want to help support the stream, all you gotta do is just retweet the link there, that's in the chat. So, it's been a long journey. There have been a lot of issues, Comcast issues, random surprises here and there, internet. Well, that's Comcast, but anyway. I'm glad that we've all... Thank you, Edder, for scrapping for 17 months. Oh, jeez, man. I'm glad that we've all managed to stick this through together. For better or for worse, it's been a pretty entertaining stream, at least for me. And I hope so for you as well. Alright. There's not really much else to say, except thank you again. Thank you again, guys. There is a new emote in the chat, and it was made just in time for the finale. So in case you don't know what it is, it's lowercase FKZ, capital O, O-P-S. And that will give you our main character. Okay, so chapter 10 is either the end or there's a chapter 11. I'm not 100% sure. Regardless, we are finishing the stream tonight. And already, you are stabbing Ayumi. I feel bad for her. Well, that's okay. Aiko and I had progressed through heavenly hosts, guided by the whims of the book. The school changing and shifting around us bit by bit, we were now faced with a peculiar marked door. Okay, well. Now or never, I guess. It's a Franker Face Z emote, which you can find by Googling, and you can download the Chrome attachment, and that's all you need, actually.
Aiko-san, Kuo-sensei wa anata no onee-san datta no ne?
Eh.
Watashi tachi, Tenjin-shou Kikan-gumi wa, jitsu wa ano hito no koto yoku shiranai no. Kiyoku ga nai...
You guys are just haters. You're killing Ayumi already.
え、ね、久保先生のことを教えて。どういう人なの?あの人は完璧な人よ。天才という言葉では収まらない。全ての理想という言葉が人間の形をしている存在。 まず 11歳の時の著書が世界的ベストセラーになったのを皮切りに文学界だけでなく科学、数学、芸能、経営、経済と数々の分野において研究や発表、マネジメントで大成功を収めているわ。公益財団法人 PL 振興社が1代の社長であそこまで成長しているのもあの人の力。
How old was she again?
私の家、庭家はあの人の印税で一生かかっても使い切れないほどの財を得ている。
Oh, hey, Brett, how are you doing?
そのせいで家族の絆は完全に断絶した。両親は子育ても働くのも放棄して、姉のお金で海外で遊び回っていて帰ってこないしね。
そうなんだ。
Aiko-san,はお姉さんのこと好きなの?
あの人は私を大好きみたいだけれど 私は大嫌いよ 昔から全部 私の前にレールを敷いてしまうから 私には選ぶ権利も与えられなかった
That's a peculiar place to start this story. So you never had a chance to even choose your own bra. That's how perfect your sister is. Well, okay, well, I guess this is a perfectly fine start to the finale. She just stuck her head into the dressing room. Whoa, okay. That's rather invasive, but that's how you felt about her, huh?
ダメよダメよダメよ! アイちゃんいい? 体に合ったものを身につけないとせっかくのスタイルが崩れてしまうの まだ若いからといって油断してると 年齢を重ねていった時に必ず足かせになる 油断大敵という言葉があるけど まさに今この時よ! こっちにしなさい! ね?
She left the dressing room for only a moment, but now handed me a luxurious, elegant, lacy bra from the gap between the curtains. Okay, I need to know how this is relevant to how you feel. You know what? I feel kind of awkward too, if I were you. I complained, but I knew I'd eventually have to try it on anyway, so I just broke down and... What if she gave you the most... You know, it is a very lacy bra, so this is kind of awkward already.
やっぱり似合うわ。お姉ちゃんが買ってあげる。アイちゃんは本当に可愛い。全部お姉ちゃんの言う通りにしなさいね。Okay,
so what's next? A scandalous pair of panties? That'd be kind of awkward too.
アイちゃんはとってもいい子だから、わかるよね? ね?
New data!
X-Foms, thanks for following. Kuan's smile was so pure and sweet, it was almost scary. Okay! You know, Aiko, you could have told me any other story except for the one you just told me now. Why was that one so important? Is it just like... Does the lacy bra represent her control over your life? Are you wearing the bra right now? Aiko, I'm gonna tell you right now. Sometimes, to gain control of our own lives, we have to be free, okay? It can be free in fighting games, it can be free... like the kid's meal toy. Yeah. But more importantly, to be free is to release yourself of that bondage that she so thoroughly thrust upon you. So I'm just telling you, you can let it go. You can unhinge the weight that is bearing you down. You can release the locks upon your heart. You know what? I don't know how many other ways I can say this, but take your bra off. And that's not a line I would use in an everyday conversation, but if it bothers you that much, then, you know, go ahead. I'll just turn around.
まあ、本当のところ、あの人のことは私もよく分かっていない気がする。え?行き過ぎた正義は悪になる。純粋すぎる悪は人を救済してしまう。
Actually, I do. And that's why I like you. I wonder where we go from here. Alright, well, starting from the top. Except I'm saving an extra chapter to read later. Well, let's see if we can go down. And we can, okay. Okay, 2 save points.
地鳴りがひどいわね。校舎が崩壊に向かっているのかも。まさかあの7番目の柱が。目覚めだ。Oh,
you can talk? I just kind of thought that the book can only grumble.
本だわ。Book of Shadows가喋ってる。
You know, now that you can talk, I kind of have a few questions for you. You know, how's life as a book? Nehan.
Meo Samashita.
Oh, well, okay. Nehan.
Okay. Well, I know who that is now. Do I want to go up is the question. You know what? Why not? I'm curious. Does this actually trigger anything? Like an event? Does a guy just pop out of nowhere and say hi?
Aiko-san, doko ni iku no?
It does, huh?
Are wa... Ano kihai wa...
Oh, cool.
Yappari. Haruyuki-kun. Haruyuki-kun yo ne? Yokatta. Watashi anata ni.
I'll be honest, I never liked you. Inumaro had been completely overtaken by the darkening. His hatred transforming into blah blah. His mouth was now slit on both ends, giving him a disturbing, almost fox-like appearance. With speed and precision, he beelined right for Aiko's neck and bit deeply into it. That's kind of him choking, not biting. You're right, I just noticed he has a command seal on his left hand.
Aiko-san!
I cut up to the two figures, where I found one seemingly trying to eat the other. Brandished the Book of Shadows in front of me like a shield, attempting to intimidate the attacker. What? Out of the blue, a girl I'd never seen before now stood in the creature's path. She was wearing a uniquely designed green pin in her hair. Looking more closely, her body had a slight sheen to it and was partially translucent. Okay. The rampaging Inumaru showed no signs of having comprehended Saika's words. What? He understands? Okay. Now she seemed to have gone through to him. He stopped biting down Aiko, releasing his grip ever so slightly. Saika's tone had a slight waver to it, belying her harshness. But her berating of Inumaru was working. His eyes were beginning to well up with tears. He was full-on bawling now, and nothing seemed like it slowed his tears. Yeah. She was less reassuring him and more commanding him. Inumaru released Aiko from his mouth entirely and became very quiet. Aiko's face was as glazed over with tears as Inumaru's. She nodded, unable to even raise her head. With one final soft, serene flash of light, Sayaka and Inumaru both dissipated into the air and were gone from sight. Well, okay. I'm pretty curious if that was... You know what? If this is the final chapter, then that's probably something that needed to happen for a good ending. On that note, I'm pretty curious if up here, nope, doesn't exist. Curiosity, yep. Not a big fan of that eye. The sound of a monstrous explosion rang out, accompanied by a violent quake that rocked the very foundation of the school. This earthquake had triggered an unfortunate side effect. The hole connecting to the underground passages had been completely sealed off. This meant that Machida and the others would have no choice but to find another way out. What? No voicing? Okay, well, I have four characters on this side, so that means if I take any damage, I can always just switch. It's not that big a problem. But to be fair, the last time I had four characters, there were instant kills the entire map, so who knows how this is gonna go. We managed to escape through the hole before it collapsed, and wend our way through numerous passages, finally arriving at the base of the enormous bell tower. As soon as we got there, however, there was another huge explosion. The whole school rocked beneath our feet. I was certain the class rep and Aiko must have felt these blasts as well. Could only hope beyond hope that they were both alright. Monstrous explosions continued to echo through the bell tower repeatedly, and violent tremors shook us again and again, seemingly without end.
Nanda!
Nanabanme no hasura ga hikatteru!
Alright.
Ai-chan. Shinosaki-san.
Itte miyo. Naomi, seotte. Isokuzo!
Well, you could barely carry your sister, but then again, she was possessed at that time, so let's try something else. Wow, really? Okay, I'm going to assume going down is not possible, but I'm gonna try anyway. Man, you gotta be really buff to do this for a long time. I can switch, right? Okay. Less dead weight. I mean, Naomi's cool too. Okay. The first one to post an Ayumi picture without killing her will be a mod only for the stream to prevent bots. Go. I intentionally said that very slowly, so someone's probably gonna kill her. Damn it, Sam! Okay, Sam's a mod. Please don't kill Ayumi. While you're a mod, you're not allowed to kill Ayumi, okay? That's the golden rule. The golden rule. Alright, your job is to kill bad bots. You know, I'm so cautious when I run up here because I'm always thinking there might be a chase scene. In which case, I would die if I ran out of stamina. But there hasn't been one the entire game up these stairs. The Sephiroth of Knowledge wasn't the only thing to be found at the top of the tower. There, waiting for us on the landing, was Magari Mizuki, holding Satsuki Mizuhara by the neck. She let go of Satsuki, who tumbled to the ground like a rag doll.
What
about you?
Oh,
see? We're thinking the same thing, right?
Sachi ni kowasareta.
Ah. Marguerite flashed a bitter smile and showed off the rubble that was once a pair of Ever After stones. She seemed almost proud of what she'd been through. Miss Kuan then produced her custom-made PL promotion stones, which had also seen better days. They were full of cracks, with a strange blue gas seeping out here and there. Marguerite scratched her head and looked, for all the world, like she resigned herself to her fate. It was a sight entirely unlike her. There wasn't anything we could do at this point but stand there and helplessly watch the pillar pulsate, knowing that it could blow at any moment. And it was then, when we'd all resigned ourselves to our fate as Marguerite had, that Miss Kuan suddenly looked down at her wristwatch and spoke.
Satoshi-kun.
Hi.
君の世界にいた私は、いい先生だった。
Just say whatever you want, man. If I had a teacher like you, I guess I'd give you an A plus as well. There's like a rateyourteacher.com. Kuan would be somewhere in the middle, and I'd be like, nah, you're not mid tier. A plus. You're top tier. Hmm? I mean, come on. She did tons of things for you. She saved your life. She chewed food for you. She made a spa in your house. Hot springs, actually. She crushed baby teeth and ate them. She's done a lot of good things. You know? I think you should just tell her the truth, man.
Nakashima-san-ga-itte-takke. Tashika, Yui-sensei.
I never received an S on my essay before, so I don't think that's an actual grade. I'm sorry, guys.
はい。君の世界って、なんでそのこと知ってんだよ。ミスト君も言っていたでしょ。オーラの色でわかるの。あなたたちは違う過去に存在していた人。あの、確かにユイ先生は 面白くてドジで最高の先生だよ。でもクオン先生だってユイ先生と同じくらい優しくて楽しくてさ。I
did give her an A plus. What are you talking about?
私も先生のこと大好き。
I was still straddling Satoshi's back. I could barely form a coherent sentence, just like right now. But I somehow knew, if I were ever to say it, that now would be the time.
Arigato.
Miss Kuan smiled brightly.
後悔もいっぱいあったけど、今の言葉で救われたかな。 天才と呼ばれたあんたでも、そう思うのね。計算の技能が早いのと、いろんな知識が豊富だったのは、単に私が異常な脳をしているだけよ。天才とかそんなのじゃない。こんな寿命まで見えてしまう人生に、あなたは魅力を感じる？
Miss Kuan turned her wristwatch so everyone could see it. The counter displayed the number 300. And it was counting down, second by second.
その時計
寿命時計、最後の1秒まで無駄にしたくなくってね。
Life clock. A device capable of reading and displaying one's own lifespan. Ordinarily, I wouldn't put any stock in the accuracy of such a ridiculous sounding contraption. But this was Miss Kuon we were talking about. Thinking back to everything she'd accomplished in the short time we knew her, and all the technology she devised through PL, I couldn't help but believe every word she said. No matter how preposterous those words may have been, nor how much I wished them to be fabrications. Miss Kuon smiled and slowly walked over to the pillar. She had the other baby tooth from Sachi in her hand.
あの子の霊力があればできる。計算上だけど間違いないはずよ。
クオン先生。
You know, on a really round note, I know this is incredibly off topic, but Tommy, when we're going to the zombie train station tomorrow, make sure that you bring your cell phone so we can take the dumbest selfies as we're being chased by zombies.Okay, let's go.
私がいなくなっても、あなたたちの人生は続くよ。どんな困難にも負けないで。
And you're gonna be like Koopa. Why don't you just bring your own cell phone? Well, my cell phone's out of data. I can't tweet live.
先生。
みんな、元気でね。
やだ。やだ。
No.Back to the topic on hand. I screamed and I cried. I lashed out. This wasn't right. This shouldn't have been the end for her.
Nakashima-san, Satoshi-kun-chi no onsen wa karada mo kokoro mo iyashite kureru wa. Mata, Yuka-chan to issho ni hairu to ii wa ne.
Tommy, please!
Kishinuma-kun wa show testoちゃんと受けること、山崎先生に話してあるからね。
ああ。
やだもう、二人とも。泣かないで。男の子でしょ。早く。もう時間がないわ。柱も、私も。
No, you don't understand, Miss Kuon. It's not that I'm crying, I just... There just happens to be something in my eye, that's all.Still on Satoshi's back, as he descended the stairs, I screamed. There had to be another way. There had to be... another way. Magari was the only one left who hadn't said anything yet.
忘れないでおくわ。あんたっていう天才を。マルトゥバは心霊医療から手を引く。
約束。してね、
アイコは私が守ってあげる。
And with that, Magari followed us down the stairs, away from the pillar. Once Miss Kuon confirmed we were all out of range,She pressed her hand, and Sachi's tooth, upon the monolith. She suddenly began to breathe heavier, as if she were running out of air. Her years were physically catching up to her, all at once. She began to feel as old as her body appeared, which would be 27, 28. She looked down at her watch. There were only 20 seconds left. With nothing left to hold them back, the tears began to stream down Miss Kuon's face. The counter was down to 10. Miss Kuon's arm began to fuse the pillar, as if she were being pulled in.
So, omoeru. Nante shiyawase nan daro.
The upper portion of the bell tower lit up with a blinding flash and exploded with tremendous force. Unfortunately, despite Kuon's sacrifice, the floating monolith was actually a nuclear warhead that had been launched directly from Metal Gear, killing all the inhabitants of Heavenly Host, and soon, the entire world. The entire school shook harder than ever, for it had never been hit by a nuclear warhead before. A piece of Heavenly Host blew out, leaving an enormous crater in its wake. A dimension of empty expanse, bright and white. A world without a Metal Gear. There, I stood, dumbfounded. You know, I'm just gonna do it once. I'm just gonna do it once, okay? And then we're just gonna drop this joke. Brother! Okay, I'm good. I need to get that out, okay? Whoa, what the hell? Whoa, this is a crazy place we're in here, man. What the? Okay, all right, okay? All right, we're good. I just had to get that out, okay? I'm sorry. I just want to do one for the Metal Gear I needed to play, and I still haven't really played for a while. Where am I? Is what I wanted to say. Okay. So, you know, I actually do feel bad that you're gone. But you're here in spirit, apparently? I'm okay with that. I guess I'm okay with that. Does that work? You know, I've always said I thought it was creepy how much you hit on Satoshi. But now, actually, I still feel the same way, but at least you're cute. I should probably have some better words for the dead, you know? If you took me up to, like, a funeral and you asked me to say words for the dead, what would I say? I don't know. What, What would I say about Miss Kuon? Okay, well, she was a talented, energetic teacher that I deeply admired. She saved my life several times, and she had the cutest smile whenever she was happy. It's kind of generic, but I get by. Except for the saving my life part, that's unique at least. And the funny thing was, as much as I liked you, I always had in the back of my head, could I really trust you? I know, right? The doubts that we have, even with the people closest to us. My face was coated in tears and snot. I stood up, arm outstretched, but there was nothing I could do. She was gone. Well, I guess I can walk on top of his eye with no problem. I'm going to assume I can't walk in those teeth, though. That'd be kind of risky. Oh, there's... Okay, so ignoring how that thing died, I'm gonna open this door. That's not how doors usually work, but welcome to this dimension, I suppose. A name tag rests beside the corpse. Lightning strike? Really? Man, that's like... one a million, dude. Huh. Ow. Wow, really? Okay, at least it wasn't the teeth. So many things on the floor that I probably shouldn't touch, that I'm just trying to figure out, like, how to get around here. Huh. Probably important. I assume is a third one, just as like a, I don't know, good things come in threes, I suppose. Hmm. Okay, there's a fourth one done. Okay, so I got five. What the hell? Jeez, get the hell out of me. Okay, I guess there's five total. I'm just gonna double check the area again. Here. Okay. The soldier bore witness to the slaughter and came to deplore it. The witch on the skewer died with naught but hate in her heart. Mothers, peer upon thy kin, hug them tight to hide thy deplorable acts. The Lord say thou shalt rebuke this massacre and meet hatred with reason. Thou canst guard against the pike, merely smile when others look upon you. Slaughter, deplore, skewer, hate, peer, hug, rebuke, reason. Guard, smile. Okay. One last check around the room to make sure I didn't miss anything. Can I check this? No, I can't. Okay. Thing on the table, obviously. Unless something just randomly sparks, I'm kind of sad. Okay, good. Nothing here. Nothing here. Nothing here. Nothing here. So I guess it's going to be five and five only. Guess that was it? Well, I mean, that was it, as in there's a bunch more. How much did you miss? You missed Miss Kuan sacrificing herself to save the others, and you missed what I think was a trigger to the good end, which was I saw Inumaru with Aiko, and we saved him due to the help of Saika's ghost. Okay, let's go over here. Can't go back down. Can I try going back up? Well, is that really it? Just this area here? Oh, yeah, I'm bra shopping. That too. Yeah, I guess that's about it. I don't think I missed anything. Wow, there are so many things to just randomly find. How much of this is going to be important? For a puzzle, I imagine, but I hope they're not, like, absolutely critical to the true end. You know, a comment like that, Phantom, could almost be considered a spoiler. I guess the question I have for you, since we're already on this line of thought, is this the final chapter? Like, I believe I asked this question before, and there is supposed to be, like, a good and a bad ending, supposedly. But the last time I played a quartz party where that was true, let me think. The path to the true ending was fairly obscure. I wasn't a big fan of it. Yeah, I'm on 10. The question is, where do I go from here? Except onto the glass, apparently. Okay, should be fine now. At least I hope so. Last time going through here, I believe I died. What the? Okay, that makes like no sense, but I'll take it. Okay, obviously relevant. Really random. Okay, I'm gonna just ignore that ignore that statue. Okay, and the fox statue, or where the hell the thing was, a dog or something? It's gone. What are we using a board for? I don't recall seeing one that's super obvious. Yeah, of course. Okay, it's not a problem, don't worry. Okay, so my options are fairly limited. So however I use this board, it's probably in the next area. At least I tried to look over everything. I think, and I really hope I didn't miss anything either. Okay, with this board though, it'll let me go across some section. The question's where? I don't really remember one. Wasn't an area to the left, correct? Sorry, what? And these had nothing in them? Correct. I believe I couldn't go up, if I remember correctly. Did it force me out before I checked the mailboxes on the other area? Sorry, I'm just going through everything that could possibly be it before I move on. I don't want to miss anything, in case it's going to be super relevant. Wish the loading times were faster, though. This game is very slow about that. Okay, well, not super relevant, but it's useful at least. I'll just save now. And I have a lot of save points, just to be careful. Okay. So the question is, where do I go from here? I have a board, I have 5 pieces of parchment that say things, probably puzzle related. I have a talisman, probably not relevant. Okay, so left wasn't possible. Right was. leads me to the library. Okay, nothing here. There shouldn't be anything in the library, but let's see. In fact, I made very sure to check everything. I don't know. At this point, he's stepping on these ground things. What does this do? Nothing. Nothing. Ow! Okay, well, I saved, so I'm going to assume this is going to hurt me. It is not a transportation device, but if it were, that'd be kind of interesting. Yep, okay, so those things pop out ghosts. But you just pop out of nowhere? Does anyone know where to go? You picked up something earlier. I can't tell if you're being serious or not. You're using FKZ oops. There was a gap before I stepped on the teeth. Okay. Well, yeah, that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for a gap. Like, in the library, I did see a gap, but what's the purpose of that gap? Like, does it even lead me anywhere? Oh, I was gonna say, what? Before library, okay. Again. Okay. I made a wrong assumption that it was just to the right, as in it was back to the other area. Did leave an item? Okay, well, whatever. Whoa, what the? Okay, can I go up? I can, and there's an impaled guy. The problem is this is very, very narrow. Was it worth it? Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, everything's so bright, it's kind of hard. Just waste your stamina now in case just more things pop out for whatever reason. There was a single white door in the back of the crystal-filled room, along with an enormous red standing cross. The walls were lined with the crucified corpses of what looked to be the Martuba investigation team sent in before us. Oh wow, okay. I can't read today. The Book of Shadows spoke once again.
もう引き返して。くどいわよ。お願い。明日待とうになるかもしれないから言ってるの。あなたが。Aiko
was at a loss for words.
ごめんなさい。
I draped my head and apologized for a sudden outburst. I intend to be looking out for Aiko, manufacturing an excuse to keep her out of harm's way, but it came across harshly. It worked, however. Aiko hung back and I stepped through the door on my own. Spooky. Inside was another realm entirely, one in which heaven and earth alike sat in ruins. The sky was a twisted coil of red and black, and the ground, or what was left of it, was little more than a black mass. The floorboards from the school stretched before me, converging at a shining staircase leading up into the unknown. And high above all else loomed a conspicuous object, shining brightest of all. That was kind of loud. Hi. On another mass of floorboards below me were Kishinuma, Uchida, Nakashima, and Magari. Yuka and Sasuke were there too, although they were an afterthought because I don't care about them.
Mina!
Shinosuke! Daijoubu ka? Nanda yo kore?
I cracked a slight smile on Machida's panicked reaction.
Minna, douka ikinokotte. Watashi, ketchaku o tsukete kuru.
Shinosuke, omae masaka.
Shinun janai wa yo.
My mind was made up. I was going to do this no matter what. I took my first step up the staircase.
Wait! Wait, Shinosuke! 篠崎。
院長。
Nakashima addressed me with much effort. She still seemed to be in tremendous pain. It was, admittedly, some comfort to read so much support from my friend. Yeah, whatever. I'm gonna do this alone again, huh? Well, one step at a time, I guess. The stairs faded away behind me, quite literally, each one vanishing as soon as I stepped off it, actively rejecting the notion that anyone but the bearer of the book could be here. I continued climbing until I hit the top, which left me right at the foot of the shining object in the sky. The last of the steps disappeared, leaving me floating in midair. I clasped my arms around the Book of Shadows. Alright guys, this, as far as I know, feels like the final boss. Help me out with one last retweet, okay? I tucked the book under my arm and started leveling myself out a bit. Almost immediately, my vision began to blur. It looks like the world around me was melting. It took me a moment to realize that it was actually motion blur due to the extreme rate of speed at which I was flying. The shiny object was getting closer and closer. So the question I have in my head right now, all the items I gathered, what's the purpose of them if this is the final boss? What? You know, I mean, if I were a final boss, I'd hit you when you're talking too. The following events all happened in rapid succession. The runic letters on my thigh from the blowback at Yoshie Shinozaki's estate began glowing red and spurting blood. Why? Why at a time like this, man? As I was observing and confirming this, four small blue lights were drawn to me like moths to a flame. Once they got within arm's length, they stopped moving and just hovered. I had a feeling I already knew the answer. These four lights were giving off a gentle, caring, friendly glow. They were the purest and strongest lights I'd encountered here. I felt reassured, and more reassured than ever, just by looking at them. In my mind, I could understand them without the need for words. Their aura was as inviting as could be. Began to cry, and then you get stabbed. That was totally cool, I guess. This was no time to lament or mourn, though. The runic letters on my arm now began glowing red and spurting blood, just as the ones my thigh had moments ago. The Book of Shadows spoke again. Alright, let's see. When the Nirvana addresses you in Footheart, you may answer back by pressing X, Triangle, and Square buttons to use the Footheart lettering of your own as indicated. Oh, okay. Really? Okay, so that's how it works. Cool. I absolutely understand exactly what this means. Okay, so cool. If I wait long enough, it just shoots me anyway. Okay, I got this. Let's just H F up M. Let's go with X. Okay, I was too slow apparently. Let's go with X. Nope, got it wrong. Cool. I can't read this shit. It's this one? Nope, got it wrong. Got it wrong. Awesome. What a great boss battle. All right, time to learn how to read.